Hey everybody, it's your favorite friend and fiend, Kenneth Ramone, back here yet again in the Cruiser Bruiser. And this time around, you guys, felt like doing some movie hunting, some random movie hunting, you know, out and about in town right now. So why don't you come along with me? Let's see what they got, my friends. We're outside the greatest place on Earth. Oh wait, that's Disneyland. Sometimes I confuse the two. Anyways, let's go see.
Are funny.
Yeah, these are pretty cool, man.
No, they're really, I mean, it's like the gimmick of like a holiday postcard.
Yeah,
but it's hilarious.
Like, I love this one, the Wally World one. I was checking this out. Like, that's so cool.
I love, like, Mortal Kombat. Visit the Outworld. Get over here.
Yeah, that's cool. It's yeah. Yeah, and that totally looks like Final Destination for sure. Look at that one. It's just a plane in the front. But, yeah, that's cool. Wow. It's got all five, so that's... Yeah, 5 for 10. That's not bad. So, pretty cool. What's this? Okay, so these are the Wonder Woman ones. This looks nothing like Wonder Woman in the front. I don't know what this is. That's fun. Okay. Yeah, like that. That's the way to do it. Okay. And right here, the guys, they have like some like rollback one. So $7.50 for the Marksman with Liam Neeson. I'm not sure of that one. Let me know if that one's any good. But guys, this one I'm really debating on getting. It's called Pig with Nicolas Cage. I hear it's really good. It's got certified rotten fresh, certified rotten tomatoes. Here it's really good. I really want to check this one out. The best work Nicolas Cage has ever done. So, thinking about getting this one for sure. And they got quite a bit of Bruce Willis films here too. I think I saw another one over here. There's that one I saw. Yeah, it was over here somewhere. Here it is. Gasoline Alley. So I know that some of like his last films are coming out. He's got a few of them coming out back to back. So thinking of getting a couple of those too. Oh, decisions. Look, here's another one. Apex. So this looks kind of cool actually. So maybe Dinosaur World. Let me take a look at this one. Oh, you gotta love it. I don't know. Dinosaur World or Jurassic Island? Decisions, my friends. Okay. And just as I learned, this is the way to put them back. Cool. Bull shark. What's bull shark? In this lake, you're the catch of the day. Interesting, actually. Yeah, I don't recognize any of the actors. Probably like some B independent movie, but that'd be cool too. So there's that. And do we talk about this one? I don't know. Here's the one that Sean was telling us about, Easter Bunny Massacre. I don't know. Maybe this is worth $10. I don't know. I have to ask Sean. I'm gonna ask Sean myself, see if it was any good. But yeah, I gotta get used to that. This is the way. That's the way to do it. Hard to do it with the phone, but yeah. That's one I picked up the last time. Really good, guys. I recommend it. Look, another Bruce Willis movie here, American Sage. I don't know about that one, but that's like the 5th Bruce Willis release, like this past couple months, so that's pretty cool. Tom Sizemore shark movie. Interesting, what's this? In the tradition of Godzilla and Jaws. That's pretty cool, man. I'm not gonna lie. Speaking of pretty cool. Yeah. I heard this one was pretty bad. Let me focus the camera low. There we go. Alicia Silverstone, The Requiem. Someone said this was really bad.
So, and like there's barely any sharks in it at all, even though the cover has a huge shark in it, there's barely any sharks in it. So it's gonna be a no for me, but they only carry the Blu-ray, so that's cool. Beneath the Surface, maybe this one's better, who knows? Maybe the cheaper one's better. It looks better. So that's cool. And Exorcism of God. Okay, no thanks. Girl in the Box, Girl in the Bunker, Girl in the Basement, 3-movie collection. You guys. And let's see what else. Jack in the Box. Oh boy. Kind of cool though. What's this one? Kristen Stewart movie. They got the slip cover and then 2 regular ones. Spencer. Let's see what this one's about. Oh, it's about Princess Diana and Prince Charles. Not something I'm really interested in, but it's certified fresh, Rotten Tomatoes, so might be a good one. I hear this one was pretty bad, so I'm gonna avoid that like the plague. No thanks. And while I'm still here, you guys, I'm gonna look for that Turbo Man action figure. And I heard it to look by the pop section. And they got the Avengers one here, but I still don't see no Turbo Man. I need my Turbo Man. I even hear that some Walmarts have it like discounted price too. So that would be cool to come across, but guys, what's this? Oh my gosh. Boris Karloff the Mummy. $20. So what is this? Is this like a mummy doll? Dude, that's actually kind of sick. They should do this with Frankenstein. That would be really cool. Like, I would totally get up on that with Frankenstein. And here's an alien one. Oops. Grab that. It's kind of cool. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. There's Stranger Things. But where's my Turbo Man? They're all gone, man. That's actually kind of cool. Look at this arcade game here. But I'm not seeing any Turbo Man. Pac-Man. I guess that's close enough. Maybe it's time to revisit the toy section. Maybe the Turbo Man action figures are here. I don't know. But just like last time, guys, we got Spider-Man, we got Avengers, more Spider-Man, Captain America, you know, Turbo Man wannabes, but, see, like, this almost looks like him, but it's not. I don't know. Maybe I should ask. Alright, let's keep looking down here. There's Batman. Lots of Batman, you know. After that movie, they got exclusive The Batman merchandise, but yeah, still don't see it. You know if they ever had those Turbo Man action figures by any chance?
Turbo Man? I have no idea.
I've never seen those.
Go back.
Yeah, yeah.
Unfortunately, I have no idea.
Thanks. Yeah.
My favorite is the Velociraptor.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that'd be kind of cool if they did have them. Yeah. Video chat, sorry.
Yeah, no, you're good. You're good. Let's see. Let's still get that one. I don't know.
The best bet would to look it up online.
Yeah.
See if we have anything. Because we used to carry Pokemon and we stopped doing that. And we stopped carrying baseball cards.
Oh, wow.
First time in how many years?
Yeah, it's crazy. That's yeah. A good day. Thank you. You guys heard it here first. No Turbo Man. just Batman. But yeah, I still might pick up these two. Definitely want to watch Pig. Do I really need this Vacation 5 film collection? I don't know, but the cover art, limited edition, travel series art looks pretty awesome. Like, what if I could, like, take this to Six Flags and, you know, have, like, the owner of Six Flags sign it? That would be really cool. Yeah, these are the things that run in my mind, guys. But that's $17, so I don't know. I still got to think about it, but definitely tempted. I'm in the toy department, by the way, while I'm sharing this with you guys. Hey guys, we're back here again, and as you may have guessed, it's been like a couple of days since I filmed that last footage, but hence why I'm wearing different clothes. But anyways, I did want to share with you guys what I did end up picking up, and then some other titles that I ended up finding like at my Dollar Tree. And surprisingly enough, I found some awesome stuff at Big Lots too. That never happens, you guys. And normally it's the same old at Big Lots, but I decided to kind of like, you know, skim through all the titles, take my time. Like, I spent like a good hour there, and I found a couple of titles that really intrigued me, and I'm so glad I ended up picking them up. Anyways, you guys, let me share with you guys what I picked up at our Walmart visit. All right, and as you guys may have guessed, I definitely had to get up on that Nicolas Cage movie called Pig. I've heard nothing but great things, you know, from fellow movie collectors out there, and this one's certified fresh from Rotten Tomatoes. Now, normally I don't go by like what critics say, like if it's got horrible reviews and whatnot, I'll still watch it and decide for myself, because I love movies that sometimes are like so bad that they're good, you know what I mean? And but in this case, you know, a certified fresh Rotten Tomato sticker definitely doesn't hurt, you know. And it's got Nicolas Cage. I've been meaning to brush up on my Nicolas Cage. I think the guy is like super badass. But anyways, ever since I saw him in Ghost Rider, I've totally dug him. But yeah, and he even like introduced Axl Rose like at the Golden God Medal Awards. Ever since that, man, I think the guy's totally badass. But it says here the best Nicolas Cage movie that he's ever done. So hey, you know, I mean, that's a good sign right there. You know, I've been meaning to watch this, haven't watched it yet, just because I've been kind of in like the comedy mood lately, you know. I've been kind of down, so I don't want to watch like a kind of like a downer movie. And I don't know, I get kind of like Sling Blade vibes from this movie, or the cover alone, actually. But yeah, so like, I'm like super stoked for this. It says here, I'm gonna read a little bit about it. A truffle hunter who lives alone in the wilderness must return to his past in Portland in search of his beloved foraging pig after she is kidnapped. So, I mean, sounds like a very simple premise, but sometimes movies like that like have like a really big lasting impact. So I'm definitely looking forward to it. It's definitely interesting. Definitely caught my eye. And this one, you know, I kept like debating whether or not I want to pick this one up, and then I just decided, you know what, there's been times where like I've actually kind of passed on titles, and then like I'll come back, I change my mind, and it's no longer there. So I definitely did not want to take that risk and miss out on this one. But you guys, I've actually been debating on picking up this Vacation 5 film collection set for a while now. And basically all this version is it has that nice fancy dancy like postcard artwork in the front of Wally World, and that's what sealed the deal for me. Okay, like I've been debating buying this like without this artwork for a long time now, cuz it was like $15 and now it's $17 with the artwork. And you guys, every time I go to Six Flags and I see this, like, you literally see this driving up to Six Flags, okay, in like the actual Six Flags logo instead of like Wally World. And every time I see that, I always tell my friends, all right, guys, we're on our way to Wally World. So it's got a lot of sentimental value for me just for the artwork alone. And that's not even to mention like the great movies on this thing as well. You know, Vacation and Vegas Vacation, those are like my top two favorite. Everybody loves Christmas Vacation, but Vegas Vacation and Vacation, definitely my favorites. But yeah, you guys, I definitely had to pick this one up. And like, you know, I kind of say it jokingly in the video, but
there's some truth behind that. Like, I definitely want to see, like, if I could actually find, like, the president of Six Flags or someone who was, like, involved in, like, the whole, like, Wally World Six Flags thing. Like, I would love to get some signatures on this thing. I mean, that's the kind of person I am, you know. That type of stuff just intrigues me. Anyways, you guys, so, yeah, enough rambling. I definitely had to pick up this Vacation 5-film collection. And, yeah, you guys, those are my pickups for Walmart. Now, let me share a little bit that I found at Big Lots. Now, like I was saying earlier, you guys, usually at Big Lots, I never come across anything. It's a bunch of crap, usually. Usually stuff that's been there forever, like old, old titles. They're usually, like, from 2002 and whatnot. Like, you'll always see, like, the first Spider-Man there. And things that I'm just not interested in, that I don't feel like I have to get up on, you know. And they have like the same titles there every time. It's like nobody buys them, so they just stick around there. But anyways, so I did some digging around my Big Lots because I'm like, somewhere in this pile is some gold in here, some gold that I've never seen before. So I'm gonna take my time, kind of look through all the titles. And yeah, you guys, so I picked up a couple that did intrigue me. First off, I'll talk about the Blu-ray that I did pick up, and this is called I, Tonya. I've never seen this movie before. Stars Margot Robbie. Of course, I love her as Harley Quinn. Anyway, so I definitely wanted to get up on this one because it's about a story. It's a true story that I remember a little bit about. Something that happened in the 90s. Some, like, figure skating drama or whatever. I know Weird Al did, like, a parody song about it. So that's where, like, I remember it from. So, like, I definitely want to learn more about it. And so, like, I kind of go to movies with, like, an open mind. So I don't want to know too much about this one. But I know it's about, like, some, like, crazy scandal that happened in the 90s. So definitely looking forward to this one. Haven't watched it yet, but it was $5 at Big Lots. So I definitely had to pick that one up. Comes with the Blu-ray and DVD and digital. So, hey, you know, that's awesome. You know, you can't go wrong with Margot Robbie. I think she's awesome. Anyways, you guys, and then I also picked up this movie called The Edge of 17. Now, actually, I'd never seen this movie before, but I know, like, the leading actress in this movie, I was familiar with some of her music when she was, like, starting out. She had a song, I think it's called, like, I Love Myself or something like that. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that's the name of the song. Haley Steinfeld? I don't know, I could be saying that wrong. Steinfeld? I don't know. But anyways, I definitely wanted to pick this movie up, and it's got Woody Harrelson in it. Now, when I saw this cover, I thought maybe this was like a movie about like a student, her counselor, and things like that. Like, that's kind of like the vibe I got from it. Now, that couldn't be far more off than what the movie's actually about. That is not her counselor. Yeah, he plays the teacher, and, like, oh my gosh, you guys, this movie was so funny. And, like, I don't even think, like, they make movies like this anymore. That's what, like, kind of, like, caught me off guard, because let me see when this movie was made. Really quick, 2016. Okay, so it's been a few years, but, yeah, I feel like this movie, like, took some risks, you know, and joked about things that, you know, are a little bit too serious nowadays that you don't see people joking about. Like, they say, like, oh, that's a serious topic, don't touch that. But this movie went there. And then I had to remind myself that this movie is actually rated R. So, like, some of, like, the jokes in there, like, I did not even expect coming. Like, because this kind of feels like a, you know, a PG-13, like, teen movie flick. But I don't know, I really wanted to watch it because, you know, Woody Harrelson's a great actor, and, you know, I remember her, like I was saying, you know, from her music. And then it says here, like, if you like movies like The Breakfast Club and 16 Candles, this is right up your alley. And I saw, of course, the, you know, I don't know, man, that's such a tongue twister, dude. Certified Fresh Rotten Tomato sticker. And then I was like, okay, well, you know what, it'll be worth a watch, you know. I need a movie like this, you know. And I really dug Adventureland, as you guys saw in my last video, like those kind of like coming of age type of movies. So if you guys know any other movies like The Edge of 17 or Adventureland, definitely recommend them to me, because I'm loving those movies. Like, I feel myself really connecting and with her character a lot, like her, like, kind of like behind the scenes, like a life story, like, you know, in this movie, I really found myself connecting with her character in many cases. So yeah, I really, really dug this movie, and I highly recommend you guys check this one out for sure. Alrighty guys, well, you gotta bear with me today. I'm so sorry that there's like this very bright glare. The sun is extra bright today. I hate it when that happens. Usually I don't get that in this spot, but you know, pretty soon I'll invest in like better cameras and whatnot. But anyways, you guys, I want to thank you all so much for watching my video. If you're new to the channel and you like what you see so far, please hit the subscribe button and please hit that like button as well. I really do appreciate all the support. Now let me get to my final pickups in this recent movie haul. Alrighty guys, so now when it comes to the Dollar Tree, I've noticed that when I go in there, they'll put like the titles out, but then you want to come back like maybe like a week or so after, because they have like even more titles that they kind of sneak in there, like after like people have bought, you know, some of the titles, and then now they have more room for other movies. So like I went back and then like I had to like dig through a lot of like the same old, same old. I don't know what's with those MGM reissue titles. They just have so many of them, and like it's just like so hard to like, you know, go through because there's just so many, man. But somewhere like in like between all those MGM reissues, I did find like some really, really cool titles that kind of took me off guard here. Like, okay, so like I found you know, Dwayne the Rock Johnson in what is this called? This is called Skyscraper. It says here in very, very tiny print. I almost thought this was San Andreas at first, and I really dug that one, but I've actually never seen Skyscraper, so this might be like an interesting watch. And as you guys could tell, the title's in Spanish and all the writing in the back is in Spanish, but one of you guys mentioned in the comments section in a previous video that these Spanish titles have the English version included in the DVD as well. So there you go, you guys. I still have to see for myself if that is so, and but you know what, I trust you guys. So I ended up picking this one up, and even if it was only in Spanish, I mean, you know, you don't really come across a Rock movie at the Dollar Tree, so I definitely had to pick this one up, let alone a Blu-ray, right? So really cool. And here's another Blu-ray from a movie that I hear nothing but great things about that surprisingly I still haven't seen because I'm a chicken, and that's called The Purge. So really cool, man. This was at my Dollar Tree. Yeah, check that out. Check out the cover, man. It looks really freaky and frightening. I don't know if I want to watch it, but for a dollar, I definitely said, hey, yeah, that's definitely going in my cart. So just like the VHS movie, the movie called VHS, man, that might just sit on my shelf for years until I finally, you know, come to watching it, because some of these movies really freak me out, man. Modern day horror, I like the ones that are like jump scare galore, like every 5 seconds, it's like, yeah, I can't do it, man. It's like, it's not even watchable anymore. But anyways, I don't know if that movie's jump scare galore. You guys let me know. I definitely had to pick it up, though. And then here's another one. Here's another certified fresh Rotten Tomatoes film called Freaks with Emil Hirsch. I think that's how you say his name. I don't know. I remember him from The Girl Next Door, man. And you know, even as an adult, I really dig that movie. So I hear this is like actually a really, really cool movie. And I don't know too much about it. I'm going to read a little bit about it. It says, kept locked inside the house by her father, 7-year-old Chloe lives in fear and fascination of the outside world, where abnormals create a constant threat, or she believes, when a mysterious stranger offers her a glimpse of what's really happening outside, Chloe soon finds out the truth, and that it isn't so simple, that danger is very real. So you guys, I'm just reading that alone, and I get like this eerie vibe, like looking at this cover. I don't know if you guys could see it, you know, with the glare going on, but I don't know, it kind of reminds me of, like, 10 Cloverfield Lane, you know, the movie where they're trapped in a bunker and, like, they can't get out, you know, to see the outside world and what's really going on, if there really is aliens taking over the world. So, I don't know, man, maybe this movie's just like that. Like I said, you know, it's got great reviews, and I almost picked this one up when I saw it at Big Lots for $3, so, and I went back and it wasn't there, of course, so I'm actually really happy that I came across this at the Dollar Tree. See, I got the last laugh. I'm really excited. I can't wait to watch this one. So it seems really cool. It's got an awesome cover and an awesome premise. So really cool, you guys. Now here's one that I've seen at the Dollar Tree before, and then I didn't pick it up, and then like I think about it a lot. I'm like, gosh, why didn't I pick that up, you know? And I have a pretty good reason for not picking it up, but it's called the Mega Shark 8 Movie Collection. Now, you guys, some of these shark movies are god-awful, okay? There's nothing that will compare to Jaws or even Deep Blue Sea or even The Meg, okay? There's really very few shark movies out there that are really, really worth watching, you know? Most of them are terrible, but, you know, some of them are worth, you know, passing the time, you know, and... you know, just for shits and giggles, right? But that was my reason why I didn't pick this one up when I saw it at the Dollar Tree months ago. I forgot how many months ago, like when I first started doing Dollar Tree hauls. But to come across this again, I said, oh, you know what? It was on my mind that one time, and I definitely like felt like I missed out. So this time, I'm taking advantage. I'm putting it in the shopping cart. But you guys, some of these titles, like Toxic Shark, Malibu Shark Attack, Shark Man, Shark Attack 1, 2, and 3, Shark Zone, Shark in Venice. Like, you guys, this sounds like really bona fide Dollar Tree movie cheese. But that being said, you know, yeah, there comes a time where you just want to turn off your brain, you know, have some popcorn and watch something that doesn't take itself too seriously. And this is the movie for that, or these are the movies for that. As a matter of fact, you guys, I picked up a movie called Nightmare Shark last time at the Dollar Tree Hall, and I got to like 20 minutes of it, and then I had to turn it off. But that is bona fide Dollar Tree movie cheese right there. Like, imagine like Nightmare on Elm Street, but with sharks. Like, sharks are coming after you in your dreams, and then like you wake up in a pool of water. Oh my gosh, you guys, I am not making that up. I still have to watch the rest of it, and I'll give you guys my thoughts on it. But oh my gosh. Anyways, you guys, now I'm just rambling, you know. Thanks for sticking in there, those of you guys that are still watching. But anyway, so at the Dollar Tree, I also came across this three movie collection called Films of Faith. And this one has God's Not Dead. And I've been meaning to watch this one because I heard really good things. And, like, even if you're not, like, a huge religious person, I hear that this is just a really, really good film. So I wanted to check it out, and it's got Kevin Sorbo in it, you know, from Hercules fame. So I definitely wanted to check this one out for sure. And it's got a couple other movies here. Woodlawn, kind of looks like a football movie right there. And it's got Indivisible, so I have no idea what those two movies are about, but I heard great things about this one. So for a dollar, hey, I felt like it was worth a shot for sure. And then here's some movies that that are kind of like B-movie galore, you know, independent film titles, but some of these movies do catch my eye. Most of them are really bad, the ones that end up at the Dollar Tree, but this movie's called They Reach. And it's like, look at all these alien hands, like, coming out of, like, the sewer and whatnot. And, yeah, I gotta show you guys this cover, because the cover looks really, really cool. So, chances are this movie's actually really bad. But, it says here, 13-year-old Jessica accidentally unleashes a demon from a reel-to-reel player, which also happens to be a doorway to the dark side. She musters her science fair winning brain power and says here, recruits two of her best friends to battle the beast and send it back to hell before more souls are taken in the small town of Clarkstown. You guys, I mean, you know, it sounds like something that's, like, really cool, like Goosebumps, cheesiness, like Goosebumps-inspired stuff with these three kids and, you know, like these hands coming out of the sewer, you know, I guess the sewer from hell. You gotta love this stuff. So, you know what, for $1.25, why not? And then here's another movie called The Device. I take it this is, like, a science fiction one. And, oh, yeah, like it's got, like, aliens coming out. It kind of reminds me of, like, War of the Worlds, kind of. Yeah, because it kind of reminds you of, like, tripods that came from underneath the ground here, but I guess it's, like, a big circle in this case. Like, it's sucking in a car. You gotta love it, you guys. It says here, what if the rumors and urban legends are real? And then it's got the dreaded sticker, so I can't read all of it. But it says here, two sisters are about to discover the horrifying truth when they find a harmless-looking object in the woods nearby their family's cabin. Oh, that sounds really cool. The small black sphere is the key to a shocking mystery that will change the course of human destiny. Wow. The device has plans for us. And the world is no longer ours. So yeah, you guys, definitely bona fide, like, War of the Worlds inspired stuff. So definitely looking forward to that. I love the War of the Worlds, you know. Hopefully this is just as good, you know. But chances are, it probably isn't. Alrighty, guys. Well, those are my recent pickups for this recent movie haul and movie shopping extravaganza. I love making these videos for you guys. You know, I know I tend to focus more of my time on, like, the music reviews and things like that, but, you know, I still like coming back to, like, this movie hunting stuff. It's a lot of fun, you know, and every now and then I'll try to film some footage for you guys to enjoy as well. But if you like videos like these, please give them a thumbs up, and I really do appreciate all the support, you know, and your guys' love for the channel. You guys rock. Thank you guys so very much for watching my video. Kenneth Ramone, signing off. Bang.